Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. This is the famous 546 edition. This is the BG, meaning Burgundy, Nelson hand size giant print. This was their flagship giant print from the 70s through the 90s. And it is arguably, which means it's not definitive, but it's arguably the best giant print that has ever been mass produced. And you can get these relatively inexpensive still on eBay and maybe even on Amazon and other places. So what is this? What this was, again, mass produced by Thomas Nelson from the 70s through the 90s. And it was a handy size, which means, I mean, it is an amazing size. I'll compare it to my Cambridge text only large print, and you can see it is actually smaller than this. So a lot of times people who need giant prints are older people, and so it is easier to carry in the hand being smaller. I'm just telling you, they sold, I have no idea how many tens of millions of these things they sold. Now, one of the cool things about this particular Burgundy one is that it had, it looks like silver lettering, which absolutely sets off this Burgundy incredible. Now, Nelson went through a time primarily in the 70s and 80s where they had a grain on their genuine leather that was totally, absolutely out of this world. I'm talking about a gorgeous grain. Now, it doesn't have raised book bands in it, but let's take a look on the inside of this thing. Has presentation pages, marriage patient, wife's family tree, husband's births, marriages. That was so important to people in those days. So this was copyright 1976, printed, believe it or not, that's right, in the United States of America. Now, one of the other things besides the size of it and the print, but Nelson came up with handy references that as you're reading, and this is still my favorite reference system, the references are at the end of the verse. And so what this allowed them to do was to make the print bigger because you didn't necessarily have to take up too much room unless the verse ended at a particular space with putting references on the side or center column reference or something like that. Now, these genuine leathers back in the day, they retailed for like $39.99, the bonded's for $29. And I'm going to tell you, the bonded leathers were out of this world as well. Gorgeous, stunningly gorgeous, and just amazing. And I'm going to show you in a moment how this compares with the inside of the Cambridge large print. The Cambridge large print. Now, so people love the church Bible publishers' Bibles and the local church Bible publishers' Bibles. But I'm going to tell you, you can buy two or three of these for the price you can buy those others that I just mentioned. And you can see that even though the print is darker in the Cambridge, the print is larger in the handy size giant print. I think the reason Nelson doesn't really print these anymore, the handy size giant prints and stuff they're printing now, just don't seem to me to be nearly the quality. Now, their new comfort print text is fantastic. Let's go to that. But just as far as quality is, I think it'd be too expensive. You think of inflation. The inflation, if this was costing $39.99 in 1976, then, and let's say $34.99 then, I think it went up to $39.99 later. That's the equivalent of over $100, I'm sure, on our inflation calculators. So I just don't think they could do it. And like this particular one, the thumb index is still there, you know. just an amazing quality Bible. Only comes with one ribbon marker, which obviously I wish it could have come with multiple. It is red letter in Revelation. And then some of their really neat study helps that they still use to this day, like the prophecies of Jesus, harmony of the Gospels. We'll measure this thing in just a minute. But I mean, it's just got some really neat features to it. But like, I cut my teeth, I like to say, on the end of verse references. You know, I'm a new convert reading the King James, and it's got the alternate translation to a particular archaic word right there, or references, or letting you know if it's a prophecy of Jesus, that type thing. Memorizing these prophecies of Messiah. That really meant a lot to me as a new Christian. Bible reading plan in the back. Summary of the books of the Bible, which is just a fantastic thing for people that are reading their Bibles. And then a decent print size concordance. It's not a comprehensive concordance, but it's an okay concordance. It's an excellent little concordance. And then Nelson used to have some of, like, kind of cool maps. Let's see if I can get these maps. You know, for this time period, these maps were really good. Excellent little maps. So this is the 546. The 544 would be the bonded leather. So you don't want to be fooled by what they're selling today. If you go to get one, you'll want to get one like this. So let's see. It's less than 8.5. It's about 8.3 inches by 6 inches exactly. That's with the, by 1.6 inches. That's just unheard of. And I'm thinking it's a 12-point print. And it's a readable 12-point print. Almost no ghosting. It's just really good. What can I say? See, I've got my 12-point thing over the D in Psalm 55 and 10 for day. And it's exact. So that would be 12-point print. So genuine leather, get you some good leather softener put on here, mink oil, some of those shoe shine things. It's already broken. I mean, this thing is excellent. So talk with you later. God bless you in Jesus' name.